Earlier this week, 50 Cent posted this post-fight photo of pro-Trump fighter Colby Covington after he lost a championship fight to Kamaru Usman. Before the fight, he promised to present the championship belt to Donald Trump and mocked his adversary's African heritage, asking, "What has his family ever done for America besides served in a federal penitentiary? Enjoy the broken jaw, you racist piece of shit." This was posted on Instagram to over 25 million followers of 50 Cent, on Twitter to over 11 million followers, and another 34 million accounts on Facebook. That's almost double the population of Canada, and more than the entire countries of Italy and France. So what's the problem? It's not true. Fake news like this, even though this is a meme, is so rampant in sports because at the end of the day, it doesn't usually affect anyone's lives. But most of the time, it's not usually spreading false information about somebody being racist to about 70 million people. What Covington actually said was more closely a complaint of the media coverage the two fighters have gotten leading up to the fight, saying, "The thing that pisses me off most about Marty Fake Newsman is saying that he's more American than me. How is he more American than me? My family has served in the Korean War, in the Vietnam War. My family has shed blood for that flag, for the red, white, and blue of America." But most people are even more upset about what he said after. What has his family ever done for America besides serve in a federal penitentiary? Why did Covington say this? Because he's evil and racist? No, it's because Kamaru Usman's father is actually in jail for defrauding the federal government millions of dollars, not because he's African American. Yes, Covington is wrong about where Usman was born. He was born in Nigeria and moved to America shortly after. Maybe his comments are a little mean, but that doesn't make him racist. To anyone who actually pays attention to the UFC and mixed martial arts, they know that Colby Covington is pretty much playing a character.
Sounds like something a nerd or a virgin would do.
The truth is, sports media is extremely susceptible to fake news, and activist journalists always do their best to try to inject identity politics whenever and wherever possible. That's why in 2018, one of the biggest MMA websites there is blocked Colby Covington on Twitter. That's why in 2019, ESPN had to tell its shows to stop talking about politics. That's why Fox Sports host Jason Whitlock gets called a race traitor for mocking LeBron James whenever he acts like a victim.
LeBron James made a complete, utter fool of himself last night with his new HBO TV show, The Shop. A year ago, while guest hosting The Herd, I upset LeBron fans by analogizing the basketball star to Donald Trump.
People want so desperately to jump to people's defense for racism on social media just to make themselves feel better and look better, not because they actually care. More often than not, they don't realize that it's them who's making biased assumptions based on people's race or place of origin. The sports world is so afraid of being offensive and looking bad that most of the time, they just make things worse. This is how Colin Kaepernick was able to get Nike deals and universal support from the entertainment industry based on saying anti-American slogans and vague things about social injustice. Because even though the sports media always caves and tries to give people what they want, they don't actually do anything besides say, "We're sorry, we'll do better."
We're sorry.
That's why when the NHL found out that a coach had said something racist 10 years ago, they had panels on Hockey Night in Canada suggesting that the company hire more black people and have more black people on camera. They came back next week with an all-white cast, from everyone in studio to the infield reporters, all white. Sorry, outrage police. You just can't have it both ways. You can't simultaneously tell people that everything is racist and is in need of a giant overhaul, and then turn around and then do absolutely nothing about it. Maybe, just maybe, a radical suggestion would be to judge people on an individual basis. Or maybe a better solution is to just change our entire society so that everything's based on likes on social media so that we can feel better about ourselves.
Correct.